Hello. Nobody's joined us yet, but I'm just waiting for people to come on. Hi. Hi. I'm online actually to be interviewed by my mum for Cope with Hope. And I'm just waiting for her to come online. I hope आप सब safe safe रह रहे हो and that everyone is doing okay. I am just trying to find. I'm so sorry, guys. I'm just trying to find my mom. Even though we're in the same house, we decided to do this in separate rooms. एक तो यहाँ पे इंटरनेट बहुत खराब है, तो हम दोनों 4G पे कर रहे हैं. सॉरी हाँ आई एम सो सॉरी आई एम जस्ट गोना बी बैक ओके आई एम जस्ट गोना चेक वेयर शी इज एंड ओ बट आई कैन टेक यू गाइस वन सेक मम्मा ओ आई थिंक शी इज गॉन इनसाइड टू गेट ऑनलाइन Mom, it's 9 o'clock. She's coming, yay! Arey, thank you all, yeah, for joining us for Cope with Hope. Waiting for Mom to come so that we can start. It's connecting. Just so that you guys know what is going on. Hi.
Hi. Hi, 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 everybody, and thank you so much. So we'll take questions in the end, right?
Yes, of course.
So I am thrilled to be interviewing my daughter, Tara Alicia Berry, today. Hi, Sharmila. Her pet name is Tasha, so if I say Tasha, don't get confused. So Tara, I mean Tashu, I know what you've been doing these past 40 days since lockdown, but would you like to tell the audience what you've been doing?
The beginning of the lockdown was very normal. I mean, what we normally do at home, cooking and cleaning and chilling. But then something wonderful happened, which was that both mom and I were approached for our, international debut project called Disconnected, which is up on YouTube now. So Matt and Anton, they called us, and so now we've been shooting, so we've been really busy. In fact, as we're talking, our footage is being uploaded on the drive so that they can edit for the next episode. So now it's been very busy the past few weeks, but initially it was very chilled out, very normal.
Okay, and will you tell them something about your projects that are showing at the moment?
Well, at the moment, State of Siege 2611 is on Zee5, which released in March, and Mast Ram, the web series, is up on MX Player. And you guys have been showing us so much love for it, and I'm so grateful because I'm very lucky. I was part of the film as well as the web series, and the amount of love that's being shown for it is beyond anything I could have dreamt of. So, thank you. Thank you all so much.
Will you talk about your love for Manali?
Yes, of course. So, you know, I always considered myself because we, as a kid, I mean, you and Priya Masi and all of us would always go for, you know, beach holidays and things like that. And I never really got to, and even though we did travel to some places that had mountains, I never really got to spend a lot of time in the hills or the mountains. And the first time for Masram, the film, when we went to shoot in Manali, it was literally like going home, because the amount of peace somehow you feel when you're in the mountains is beyond imaginable. I think even this time when we shot the web series, somehow being there, it just clears your mind completely, you know. Just, I mean, it's where it's like home for me, Manali. A home, I mean, my heart's home.
Your heart's home. That's lovely. Will you tell us a little bit about Poroma and your role in Love, Lust and Confusion? I'm sure all of you have seen that, but I'd like you to tell them about Poroma, not about Tasha, but about Poroma and her character. And do you have any similarities to that character, or do you not have any similarities?
So, I don't know if I think I'm more similar to Momo. I don't know how similar I am to Poro, but because Poro is someone who is very confused, for lack of a better word, because she doesn't really know what she wants is constantly changing. And I think there are a lot of young people out there who do feel like that. You know, it's constantly changing. They're not sure. They're passionate about one thing, but when it comes to other things, they're like, you know, not 100% sure. And I think I'm the complete opposite. I've always been very sure of things and very sure of what, you know, what I want to do, the kind of people I want in my life, everything, everything, everything. And Poro is still figuring stuff out, you know, and she's exploring things. And I think that's, you know, I'm very grateful to Victor for writing this part and for giving me the opportunity to play Poro, because I feel, you know, people are very judgy with people who are like Poro, you know. But she's so young and she doesn't need to have it all figured out. Yeah, like, why do people talk about? I mean, why do you have to have things figured out ever? I feel, you know, so what? So what if you're confused? So what if you really don't know? It's okay. Some of us don't have it all sorted in our minds and hearts. You know, we don't know what's going to make us happy. We don't know that. Sometimes it takes, you know, decades and decades for people to figure out what will give them true happiness at any time. And that changes also. Like today, what I thought would give me happiness when I was 13 may not necessarily be what, you know, I believe now. I mean, the things that I believe that will give me happiness now. So I think I'm very, very glad. And the thing is, a lot of women, a lot of young girls have sent me, you know, messages saying that they're so glad that there's a part like Poro being portrayed on screen, because they have felt judged and they feel like, you know, it's okay. Because Victor has written it in such a way, all the characters, without any judgment. You know, people are complicated, yeah. And Poro is complicated, and she's complicated, and she's not one-dimensional, and she is exploring her life and her own inner truth.
So, talking about exploring life and her own inner truth, and talking about happiness, so that's Poro. What is it that gives you happiness? What is it that gives Tara happiness right now?
Right now, I think just actually, my mind is so, because we've been shooting today, my mind is like, I'm just thinking ki, what would have given me today. I was very happy because I got to do what I love. I mean, I don't think that there's any point in my life these days where I feel like, you know, I don't have a thousand things to be grateful for and therefore to be happy about. But I do think that, you know, peace, drama, like contention and things like that. I think those things are necessary to be happy, because, I mean, ultimately today, if you're in a situation or in any situation where there's a lot of, drama and contention, it can get to you. You can feel low. So I think it is important, especially now with the lockdown, I'm hearing so many stories of people who are stuck in situations, with family members or partners, and things are very unhappy, and I really feel for them, because there's no way out, and I just feel like I think that it's very important that everyone staying together, and everybody who's in one's life, is at least for me, in my life, doesn't want that drama and contention and things like that. I think that's very important for, mental peace and happiness. And I'm very lucky, because, I can't complain. I have a wonderful life, just look at us today. We've been up since, 7 o'clock, 6 o'clock in the morning. Up, ready, and ready to roll at 8 o'clock, and we've been shooting for one of the most amazing projects that I've ever done, and I know that you feel that you've ever done. Yes. So, wow, that gives me a lot of happiness.
So tell the audience about because some of them may not know how Disconnected is shot. So will you talk to them a little bit about how it's shot?
So my partner, Umang, is also here with us, and he's been shooting Disconnected for us very kindly. He's a musician.
And he's not a cameraman.
He's a musician, and he's been doing it. And we were first shooting on using Filmic Pro and shooting on an iPhone 6S Plus. Yes. Both Mama and I have ancient iPhones. And anyway, so we were shooting on that, and yesterday we managed to get a camera. So now we're shooting on a proper camera. And luckily, Umang is doing constant research and things and figuring out, what to do. And we have a fantastic AD on call all the time, Hitesh.
And tell them which other countries are involved and how that all the actors are shooting their own film.
One of the actors who's with us on the show is here.
Hi, April.
In the UK, and people are shooting in the UK. People are shooting in LA. People are shooting in Rwanda.
So April, I want to interview you next week. I'll DM you for Cope with Hope. So this is really exciting, because every actor in their different cities, in London, in Rwanda, in LA, in Ohio, everybody is shooting themselves, on whatever's available to them. So it's really quite a crazy project, and I think it's an actor's dream to be part of this project. Besides that, there are many, many requests for you to sing two lines from Poro's song.
Dil ki nayi nayi baatein hain, sapne inki nayi ishaare hain. Suno halchal machate hain, raat ko jagate hain, panchi pagal hai. Bas.
I don't know. Well, sing that part.
Huh?
Sing the chorus.
No.
Okay. So now I want you to tell them, if your life was a movie, I know you play a lot of roles as an actress. If your life was a movie, what genre do you think it would be? And who would you like to act in your part?
I think it would be a dark comedy. and who I would like to act in my part. I don't know. It depends. I can't answer this question. I don't know who
you
I
have
would,
to.
Who I would like.
You
to
you play. Can you can choose five actresses, not just
five.
One. Yeah.
Oh my god. I'm just trying to think. I don't know. I honestly don't know. No.
I put you on a spot.
No one is gonna.
Okay. What does hope mean for you?
Hope.
Yes.
Hope is something that I feel, you know, I'm very, very lucky that I've had a lot of help. I mean, a lot of help and a lot of people in my life who've come at the right time, as you know. Because I think I have had times, as I'm sure many, many others have also, where I've been completely hopeless and thought, you know, I mean, and really had zero hope and wondered, you know, what am I doing here and what's going on? And I know a lot of people have these thoughts, you know, especially when they're kids, even when they're older, and nobody again says that it's okay, you know, and some and there are many, many people that you can reach out to. So hope for me is something that I've had to learn to have. You know, like I've seen you, you've always been hopeful, you've always been positive, you've always had trust. For me, it hasn't come that easy. It's something that I've really had to learn, you know. I've had to learn it, you know, from you, from Priya Masi, from various people in my life, you know, Chandni, Umang, you know, my therapist right now, who my therapist right now. I mean, so many people have taught me how to be hopeful when I've felt down and out. And I think that all is not lost for people who don't feel hopeful naturally. I think it's something that you can, you know, learn how to feel and really make sure that you do, because life is really sad without hope.
So do you feel, for you, hope has been like a process? It's been a process to get there?
It's been a process, yeah, of course. And it's an ongoing process. I mean,
It's still a process?
It's an ongoing process. I feel like it's much easier now, I feel like. It's much easier now because I've been, again, given tools by people, you know, on how to feel hope in those times where I'm not feeling so hopeful.
Yes.
And I think that I'm so lucky, yeah, because I have so many good people around me who are very positive and very hopeful naturally. So I have a lot of support.
Yeah.
So yeah, but it is a process. I mean, it doesn't come easily. I mean, it doesn't come easily to everyone. It's something that can be learned. It's something that to trust and to be hopeful is something that can be a learned skill. And it can change your life completely.
Yes.
Because what can be better than being hopeful? Like right now, we're in times which are so difficult for so many people. And just imagine if hope didn't exist, you know, it would be that much worse.
Yeah, true. Love. Where does love fit into your life, and what is your meaning? What is your description of love?
I think love is when, firstly, love is everything. I mean, I don't think that anything can be beyond love. And I don't mean romantic love, as I know you know. But I think love is when you truly, truly wish for another being's happiness and peace, you know, more than anything else. And I think love is that feeling that fills your heart so much that you just can't contain it, you know, you have to sort of, like, it cannot be contained. And whether that means that you express that in your work, or you express that with kindness to the people around you, whether you express that through, you know, art or music or painting, or art and painting, I'm saying, or whatever it is, you know, just sitting and looking out of the window and feeling so much love. I mean, that, or meditating, I mean, there's so many ways. I think love is everything. Love is beyond. Love is home.
Love is home. And I love what you said. True love is like wishing in your heart that somebody else is feeling everything, you know?
Yeah.
To wish it for somebody else. I mean, that's such an important part of what we're going through right now, is that like we have to consider the other. We have to consider everybody in our own little way.
Yes.
So that's very, very, very beautifully said.
Even if that's with a little prayer, even if that's just a little prayer, in your mind. Even if
to send it out there.
Or just a happy thought if you don't believe in praying and things.
Yes. Yeah. Beautifully put forth. Now a different topic altogether, like almost like a rapid fire. Five roles that you would have loved to do.
Five roles?
That you would have loved to do. Your five favorite roles.
I think Alexis in Schitt's Creek, for sure. But I don't think that anyone can play that part. I don't think there's another person, because she's just phenomenal.
Yeah.
I think more than five roles, I mean, more than five roles that I like to play, they're kind of parts that I haven't gotten the opportunity to, and I would love to. Like, I would love to play, you know, like a psycho killer.
Because
I've
not
had the opportunity to do that. Yeah, like something like Killing Eve. I would love to play.
I will not watch like that.
I would love to play a character like Alexis. I would love to play a character like I've forgotten her name right now. But in Magicians, Margot, in the Magicians, you know, somebody. She's someone who. Initially, you may feel, oh my God, like, you know, she may not be so likable, but then you end up just falling in love with her because she's played the part so well, and it's such a well-written part. I would love to play Poirot again. I hope I get the opportunity. So that's four. And the fifth one, I would like to play, I don't know, like maybe a warrior or, you know, something like that. Something like
a warrior. Done. Wow. Yeah, I would love to watch you as a warrior. I think you'd be brilliant. I really think. Yeah, I would love to. I would love to watch you.
Yeah, warrior, or like something along those lines.
What has been your most embarrassing moment on set?
On set?
Yeah.
I don't know if it's been embarrassing. But I think, I don't know. I've never been embarrassed on set.
No?
No, I've never been embarrassed on set, ever.
What has been your most fun moment on set?
Fun moment? My most fun moment on set ever?
Yeah.
I think it was today when Bacon came in the middle of the shot.
Bacon is a little cavapoo who just bounces around the place like a rabbit.
Yeah, and we were losing light and trying to shoot, and Bacon kept coming in the shot. It was damn cute. But then we had to put him in the other room. But yeah, I think that. Bacon related.
Okay. Can you tell the audience something you've been doing besides our shooting together? Something that you've been doing that has given you a lot of fulfillment at this time? And that you found has given you peace and a lot of balance, you know? I mean,
I think, honestly, what gives me a lot of peace and balance at any time, and which has continued even now, as you know, is keeping up with my routine. So, like, waking up in the morning, doing my sadhana, you know, having breakfast, doing my workout. And luckily, Meeta, our yoga teacher, has agreed to do online classes, and that's something that I really appreciate. And so keeping up with the routine, with my routine is something that gives me a lot of peace and happiness, because it's something that I do it wherever I am, whatever I'm doing, even if I'm shooting, I'll wake up, you know, early so that I can do those things before going on set, as you know. So I think keeping my routine, especially in the morning, second half of the day is fine, but the morning routine is something that really, for me, very important.
So would you say it's a good way to keep yourself structured at this time?
At any time.
Okay, any last words of wisdom, any last Tara mantra for life that you'd like to share with our audience?
Tara mantra? I think the Tara mantra for life is chalo, chalo, chalo. Which is again very hopeful, because when you're not feeling hopeful, there's no chalo, chalo, chalo. And I know you're laughing because this is what I see on set all the time.
Chalo, chalo, chalo.
And I think that's my... Yeah, that's my mantra. I mean, I think it's been like that since I was a kid. Like, without knowing it, I've been chalo, chalo, chaloing. And that's what you have to do. Like, just chalo, chalo, chalo.
So this chalo at all levels of your being, physically, stretching the mind, stretching the emotions, that way chalo, chalo, chalo?
No, not stretching. Just like persevering. You know? Not going really forward. Stretching, but not going forward, but just, like that effort, you know, the effort, just that constant, like, self-effort. I think
constant
that's what
self-effort.
Is, yeah,
so
like,
chalo, chalo, chalo is constant self-effort.
Yeah, like, constant self-effort, like, how, you know, moving forward, but in a way, in the sense of growth, like, that chalo, 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 you know, like, imagining, like, you're sitting and looking... I mean, you're the seed, and you're telling yourself, like, you know, chalo, 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 like, okay, come on now, you can, you know, you can sprout, you can grow, you can become that huge tree, you know, you can bear fruit or whatever, which I guess is also very hopeful.
Yes.
So, yeah, chalo, chalo, chalo.
So, you innately have that hopeful part of you. Isn't it? Chalo, chalo, chalo. Okay, so there are some questions there. Would you like to go through them and answer them? And then we can wrap up.
Questions. So many people are here. Manjuvani, hi.
Hi, everybody.
Chanda.
Sanjay.
I'm really sorry if I've missed anybody, like, honestly, because I'm trying to go back now and look through the questions. But thank
Erica,
you for all the
auntie.
Sweet comments about Poro and Mastram, and what kind of traits would I like to see in my lover? That's one of the questions. Well, honestly, I think I've gotten pretty lucky with my partner. And all of his traits.
So you can elaborate on two of them. One is that he's a brilliant cameraman, which he self-taught himself during these times.
That's not a requirement. He's the most giving, kind person I've ever met. Which Netflix series am I on now? I am on Stories by Rabindranath Tagore, which is on Netflix. And I'm in the first story, which is Chokhir Bali. And that's 3 episodes. What other? Mastram season 2, as soon as it's coming, we will let you know.
Which is your next series? Her next series is the one we're shooting right now.
Called Disconnected. And it's already on YouTube. I've posted, it's in my highlights. And I'll keep posting the new episodes. How are you when you're starting? Hi, Mama, this question is for you. When are you starting your meditation series?
Okay, so from next week, I'll be doing meditation every Monday and every Thursday. I'll announce the timings tomorrow for Monday. So the day before that, I'll announce the timings. And on Monday, I'll do it on Facebook Live. And on Thursday, I'll do it on Instagram and then see and then ask you where I should do it, the audience. Okay? But I'll always post a video of it after that.
Someone is asking if I have a problem with my eyes.
Do you have a
Huh?
problem with your eyes?
Mother and daughter, we're both challenged. क्या करें?
Tara, any new Tamil projects? Your film is ready to be released,
Yes,
isn't
this
it?
fourth is ready, which is with Santanam sir. And someone asked me to talk about Santanam sir and working with him. Honestly, it's been the most amazing experience, A1 mein and also in Biscoff, because he is, I mean, just a complete delight to work with on set. You're constantly laughing. He's such a humble person. He's such a kind person. And you know, I hope that we do many, many more projects together. I just love working with Santanam.
Somebody's asked if you
And
were not
Erica
an actor.
Auntie,
Sorry.
sorry, Erica Auntie wanted me to talk about Bacon. He's the cutest ever, you know. Bacon, if you spend even like 1 second looking at his picture, also you feel happy. That's Bacon. Sorry, mom, what
If
were you
he's
saying?
there, get him into the camera. If he's there, bring him into the camera.
He's gone for his walk, I think.
Okay. Somebody's asked, not an actor, what would you be?
Probably a vet or something to do with animals, I think, for sure.
Yeah? Well, she's a great cook also, huh, guys? My
I
question
love
for you
cooking.
is, what is your favorite holiday destination? Someone's asked.
Manali and London.
Some small trips for meditation, you will get them on Monday and Thursday. Yes. Just quietly with your eyes closed.
You know what? Somebody also
Somebody had a
told
big
me,
crush
next meal at
on
my
you when they've
place
seen Love,
would,
Lust, and
yes, Sharmila
Confusion.
Auntie, for sure. Just tell me what you want me to cook and I will cook it. Which book am I reading? I'm reading
You were
the
giving
book
them
Thief,
some
actually.
tips.
Sorry, mom, what do you think?
You were stiff about meditation, I think.
Yeah, about meditation, you know, I read somewhere that you can do it at any time, like at any time, no matter what you're doing, if you just focus on your
Yeah.
breath, like even if you're cooking or you're, you know, you just focus on breathing in and breathing out while you're doing that activity. Yeah, and it's really like, I mean, it's a meditation in itself.
Yeah. Which is what I'll do on Monday. On Monday, I'll teach you two, three different short little breathing exercises that you can do at any time, no matter what you're doing. Hi, somebody's from Dubai. Everybody wants to know about love, lust, and confusion.
You know, as soon as I have an update on Lovelace and Confusion, I will definitely, definitely, definitely post about it. For sure.
Any last minute, anything you'd like to let them know about?
Nothing, absolutely nothing. I think we've covered everything. I'm so glad that everyone joined us.
Yes.
And oh, someone else is asking. Sorry.
Answer now. What's your favorite dish?
My favorite, Rajma Chawal. Rajma Chawal and also Kali Dal and Lachha Paratha.
The best kali dal, let me tell you. Yum. Anything else? Okay, what is the
No,
first thing you
that's how
do?
Erica
What was the step
answers.
out?
When I can step out, I'm pretty sure once the lockdown ends, I'm gonna be like, I just feel like staying at home. No, but I'll meet my friend Chandni. I'm really missing her. I'll meet her and yeah, give her a big hug.
Okay, thank you for doing this with me. She's the one who named it Cope
Thank
with
you,
Hope.
Mama.
Thank you for that. It was lovely. And thank you, everybody, for watching. And please keep watching my videos. Bye. Bye,
Thank you.
everybody.
Thank you. And also, all
Bye.
the videos are on Cope with Hope are on YouTube. So please go on YouTube and subscribe, like, share, watch. So yeah, love you all.
Bye bye. I'm sorry for the internet being a little grainy. Bye everyone.